Hey guys, it's Kamri. I'm here studying for this history exam. We're learning about medieval military machines called trebuchets. They're like fancy catapults that threw all sorts of things over castle walls. Rocks, fiery cannonballs, or flaming liquids. Cool, huh? I've asked Nat Geo to send me someone to help me study.
Did someone say medieval military machines?
You got here fast.
Tom, mechanical engineer and medieval machinery enthusiast.
Kamri, high school student. I'm studying trebuchets.
Ah, beautiful machine.
And I wanted to know how it generates the force to throw a boulder.
Well, trebuchets consist of a lever and a sling. When the lever rotates, it swings around the fulcrum. As the long end of the lever nears the apex of its arc, the sling whips around over the top, opens up, and releases a projectile.
So if the trebuchet used heavy rocks as ammunition, how did anyone rotate the lever?
A team of soldiers would yank down on the short end of the lever with ropes, accelerating the long end and creating kinetic energy to launch the projectile.
So what is that?
That is a counterweight trebuchet, far larger than its person-powered cousin. The counterweight trebuchet relied on a massive box filled with dirt, sand, and stones. The box is hoisted into the air, and the trebuchet is cocked with a pin, creating loads of potential energy. Removing the pin allows the box to fall, throwing boulders hundreds of feet through the air.
So soldiers would use these to throw rocks?
And flaming liquids.
And flaming liquids.
Let's demo.
Yeah.
Ready?
Whoa!
So sorry.
It's okay, it's Nat Geo Kids window. So why would one object go further than another one on the same trebuchet?
The greater an object's mass, the greater the force needed to move it. Thus, if two different rocks are launched by the same trebuchet, the stone with the lesser mass will travel further.
Thanks for your help. I think I'm gonna do great on my exam.
You're quite welcome, Kamri. Now, if you'll excuse me, someone needs my help building a battering ram. Onward!
Now that you know how that works, catch up on all the other episodes of How Things Work by clicking right here. And also make sure you subscribe to Nat Geo Kids by clicking down here. See you next time. Bye.